एक्चुअली दैट डे व्हाट हैपेंड, आई मिस सम पॉइंट्स. सो फर्स्ट बट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, एज पार्था वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट हीलिंग राहु, सो
Yes.
या सो वी हैव टू डू इट नाउ. सो देर आर एक्चुअली एफर्मेशंस टू हील राहु. सो राहु एनर्जी हीलिंग एफर्मेशंस, देर आर इन टोटल फोर एफर्मेशंस टू हील राहु. सो आई वुड लाइक टू स्टॉप माई वीडियो फॉर गुड स्ट्रीमिंग, अदरवाइज
All right.
या इट विल कॉज प्रॉब्लम. तो फर्स्ट वी विल शेयर द एफर्मेशन टू हील राहु. इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्चुअली फॉर ऑल वेस्टर्न ऑडियंस एंड वेस्टर्न फ्रेंड्स. आई विश टू टेल यू ऑल, आई विश टू अनाउंस दैट राहु, डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज विद दिस वर्ड, फोर लेटर वर्ड. राहु इज नन अदर देन योर शेडो सेल्फ, डार्क सेल्फ. It's very important to heal your this inner side of you yourself. So don't get confused with the word. He is Rahu. So first set of affirmation, there are three sets of affirmation. First set was prepared by Partha, and the rest two had been prepared by me, and the fourth one is also prepared by Partha. So you have to. It will the repetition will free you from all karmic baggage, from all dimensions, spaces, realities, times, time loops and timelines. Some people believe in reincarnation, so for them it is not time loop but lives or previous births or future coming births, and I call it time loops. There are some affirmations, please repeat each set for 5 times and then take 3 breaths from the universe and three and give 3 air blow to the universe to seal the affirmation. So how to give the 3 blow to the universe, I will show you. First of all, the affirmation, first affirmation, I heal Rahu, I forgive and release Rahu in all timelines and dimensions. I release and forgive my ancestors and all ancestors in all timelines and dimensions. All cuts and wounds in the currency is completely healed in all timelines. I release and forgive all. We release the I all. I release and forgive all. Full stop. We release Cain hyphen coin in all timelines and dimensions. It's very important. I can share this affirmation. In fact, I gave it to many persons, but I can give it again.
Yes, I've got it.
We release Cain hyphen coin in all timelines and dimensions. And again, one stanza is there. Rupee, dollars, euro, pounds are healed, slashes, cuts, wounds released and healed. Cain is equal coin is equal cut is equal slash is equal curse. All currency symbols have slashes or cuts on them. Currency are cursed. So I heal the currency or
They do.
money. So I heal the currency or money. Money is time. Time is illusion. Illusion is Rahu. Rahu needs healing. And you can add a thing also that Rahu is our shadow self or dark self. You can add or you cannot. It's okay. All cuts and wounds in currency is completely healed in all timelines. You can add spaces, realities, because I have written these dimensions, spaces, realities, time loops, and timelines. So write this down and affirm. You can affirm for 5 times and you can affirm for 11 times. As it is a, I mean, it's a very long affirmation, so you can do it 5 times also. Now, here is second set of affirmations. Affirmations for Rahu, ancestor, shadow self, acceptance, healing, and releasing. First thing is that you have to accept that self or Rahu, then you need to heal and then you need to release. That same divine triangle is there also. So, there will be this. I seek forgiveness from Rahu in all dimensions. I know what happened with Rahu was unjust. So I seek forgiveness from all and I forgive all in all dimensions, timelines, time loops, realities, and space. I seek forgiveness from Rahu. Pitris means ancestors, my ancestors in all dimensions, timelines, time loops, realities, and space. I request Durga, as Durga is Rahu's soul or super conscious. I request Durga to make Rahu happy and release souls from the time bondage in all dimensions, timelines, टाइम लूप्स रियालिटीज एंड स्पेस हियर आई पुट नमस्ते विद अ रेड हार्ट बट इट इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन पावर पॉइंट द रेड हार्ट कम होम चाइल्ड फॉरगिव योर पेरेंट्स योर फादर वी नीड योर सपोर्ट थर्ड सेट ऑफ अफर्मेशंस I accept, heal, and release all characters in my astrological charts and burn all the karma attached to these characters. I have learned my lessons and I am on the right path now. I am successfully carrying my soul mission in all levels, multidimensionally. I am free, I am enlightened, I am opened, I am expanded. I expand the idea of what is possible. As I expand the idea of what is possible, I bring it in. I am the universe infinite in every direction. I am love. I am forgiving. Repeat all sets of sets for 5 times for 5 days, 14 days, 23 days or 41 days or 55 days. 55 days is better. You have perhaps heard about the magic of 5. So it's like that for 5 days also you can do. For 55 days you can do. So I said, I read all these three, I think, third, first, second, third. So now, this is a special affirmation. Whenever eclipse happens and whenever full moon is there. So whenever eclipse happens and whenever full moon is there. So write and read for 5 times. Same formula, 5 times for 5 days or 14 days. It's like that. So it's bit longer. I affirm that I release all those who had hurt me in this life, starting from my childhood. I release the physical, emotional, mental, psychomatic wounds that were impinged on all of my 5 bodies, namely physical body, annamaya kosha, energy body, pranamaya kosha, these all are Sanskrit, mental body, manomaya kosha, intelligence body, vijnanamaya kosha, etheric bliss body, anandamaya kosha. I release all the accumulated karma, sanchit karma, that has been caused due to physical and mental torture and trauma that was inflicted on me. I release all the people, situations, and the karma associated with it in all timelines and dimensions of my present incarnation. I open all unhealed emotional wounds, heal them with intent, and release that karma, people, and situations associated with the emotional wound. I forgive all of them. Thank you, love you, and release all. I seek forgiveness from all the people whom I have hurt physically, mentally, emotionally. Where's that line? Emotionally in the current lifetime. This is very important to call it current lifetime. I request the source to heal all the physical and emotional wounds that I have been caused. And I request all the souls to forgive me in all timelines and dimensions. I also seek forgiveness from the source, creator, and all the healing angels and ministers for any mistakes that I may have made in the affirmations. I request the healing source and angels to correct them and heal all. I also release all the two-legged and four-legged creatures who may have hurt me or whom I had hurt knowingly or unknowingly. I love all and I thank all. These are the affirmations. And interestingly, I want to share something more. Yeah. So we can give this affirmation to anyone. Those are interested. We were discussing about Sushant Singh Rajput. Can you see this?
Yes.
Okay. So this is a random Twitter profile. I checked yesterday when it was 474 followers. I took the screenshot. Actually, it happens every time. It's not possible to take a screenshot. But why I took the screenshot? Because just right after that, I saw one video video was there about Sushant Singh Rajput. So it was there that the lady, Filmy Indian, she does very good videos. She supported Sushant Singh Rajput. She told all good things about Sushant Singh Rajput. And see the views, 4.7 million views. So see, Sushant, this 4747 is very attached to Sushant. So he has also the code of Rahu. He is the golden sun. we have already discussed. He has also the code of 47 optimal timeline reality. So now I would like to show you some videos, only two videos. This is about, can you see this? This is his home.
Yes.
So this is only 2 minutes, 19 seconds. So you All see right. what was there in Sushant's house. It's very, you know, symbolical.
Okay.
That's the telescope.
Quite a scope.
Yeah.
We can't hear him.
Yeah. Can you hear?
No, I can't hear him.
Okay. Actually, I want to show you the telescope mainly. The telescope thing is there, and this is the special telescope where he wanted to look at Andromeda.
Yes.
The chained lady, the lockdown period, yes. The chained lady. The Sita, the Andromeda, and definitely he is the Perseus. He has that Perseus code. So many ancestral things are there. This Almira, all old Almira, as you can see, it is very old furniture he had. He loved ancestral things. There was one. These are very old furniture he had, and everything related to ancestors. See, these all are very old. Anyone can spot. And he also told here that he is very interested in vintage things. See, this is a very old table. And he was definitely. Can you hear?
Oh yeah. Well, I can hear him.
Yeah. Yeah. Pardon?
I can hear you.
Okay.
I can't hear him.
Okay.
Machine. Beautiful telescope.
Yeah, they're very beautiful.
This is the telescope, Miari 600, and you can see Saturn rings, Jupiter moons, and actually different galaxies, Andromeda also, when the sky is clear.
He just talked about Andromeda. Did you hear Andromeda and Jupiter and Saturn rings?
Not at all. No, we can't hear him at all.
Yeah, and he loves a doggy also. He has a doggy. Oh. Very beautiful soul. He was a very beautiful soul. And see, he has a war station. He has one war station also. This is his car, definitely. So that was one video. And there was another video also, very important. Yes. Can you see my laptop screen?
No, we're still on the video. The Fine. WhatsApp video.
Fine. I will show you now. When he was at CERN.
Yes.
When he was at CERN, I think you cannot hear the voice still, but anyway, I will show you. Happy guy.
Very.
That's the Brahmagupta Shunya that I covered yesterday, I think the day before yesterday. That's the God particle. His God energy activated there. That is the Nataraj, the dancing Shiva, the apocalypse dancing Shiva, Nataraja. One fires for a form of Shiva. So we can see the relevance actually, Charles. Nataraj Shiva. Okay, window is closed. Nataraj Shiva was that form of Shiva. when so after Sati died, the Nataraja Shiva, he danced with the fire's movements, and then the other gods have to make him cool, and he was like fiercely, he was destroying the whole cosmos. So he is the Nataraja Shiva, and it was said that that Nataraja Shiva, who was dancing the Tandava dance, if I'm not wrong, sometimes I got wrong with small facts, but anyway, so all kinds of emotions came out from his dance, like 9 rasas. So it was also said, wow, like, yeah, so beautiful illustrations was there. And one Michael Jackson also said to heal our world. So actually it is very important right now to heal our world. So with what essence we can heal the world? I just want to show another video. It's 3 minutes. I think you all can listen to this. You can see this. I hope so.
Right now we see you.
Can you see?
Ah, there we go. Yes.
Is it audible, this video?
Hit play and let's see if we hear.
Is it audible, the voice?
Very low, but yes.
Okay. I will do it. Actually, it's a very beautiful message, and it's an old Bollywood song, sang by a very famous beautiful singer. He's no more now. It's just saying that although we hail from different lands, we share the same sky, earth, and sun. Oh, friends, don't forget that we are one. So it's a very beautiful. I think it's very relevant. All people should watch this.
Hail from different lands, we share one earth and sky and sun. Remember, friends, the world is one. Although we hail from different lands, we share one earth and sky and sun. Remember, friends, the world is one. We want all enmity to cease, for we want peace, we all want peace. We want no hate, we want no strife, since we were born for love and life.
One key word is love and life.
Yes.
Come, let us chant while joining hands. We shall not rest till wars are done. Remember, friends, the world is one. Although we hail from different lands, we share one earth and sky and sun. Remember, friends, the world is one. We have met here to dream and build. We want our dreams to be fulfilled. We have come here to dream and plan a world of joy and hope for man. Our his dignity, dear man, a world that we shall see begun. Remember, friends, the world is one. Although we hail from different lands, we share one earth and sky and sun. Remember, friends, the world is one.
Thank you, Charles, for letting me to play this song. I don't know whether you understood the accent.
Yes, absolutely.
I think
it, very much.
It's pure Indian accent.
Oh, it's beautiful.
But the message is very, very beautiful. I think this is the this is like living under one or living with oneness with the one infinite creator with love and life.
Amen.
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 Actually,
wonderful.
We don't think we have much left to fight over anything. So with this positive note, Charles, I want to hand over my mic to Partha. And I will make him host, I think.
All right.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Okay.
Hi, hey, Partha. Angel and Charles, are you able to hear me?
Yes,
Partha.
Okay. So if there is a drop or something, please do inform immediately.
Sure.
Will do.
Okay. As she was saying, you know, about Sushant and a few important things. So he went to the sun, and in sun there is a Shiva statue. Everybody knows that. Not only that, he acted in this movie called Kedarnath. It is a movie on the tragedy that happened in Kedarnath state. So before that, I'll just show you this. His car number is 4747.
That's right.
And he has this Shiva trident.
Yeah.
So this was the tragedy which happened many years ago, I think in 2012 or 13, I have to see. Media. Okay.
What happened here?
2013. Are you able to hear me?
What happened at the village? A cloudburst?
It's not village. It was the entire North India. A multi-day cloud burst centered the North Indian side of Uttarakhand caused severe devastating floods and landslides. It is the worst natural disasters to strike India since 2004 tsunami. So, a lot of villages and a lot of people died. People say it is 5,000 people who died. 3 lakh pilgrims were trapped in the valleys. So this movie actually in which he acted is based on that tragedy. So she is a Hindu Indian girl. He is an Indian Muslim boy. So Muslims in India, they I think they came some 1,000 years ago or 800 years ago. And they ruled India for I think 600, 700 years. Then the British came, British ruled for another 200 years. So, but still, you know, in terms of, it is similar to, you know, this Black Lives kind of thing, you know, where, you know, there is still a lot of disharmony and all that. There are moderate Muslims and then there are Muslims who are upset with, you know, the treatment which happens to them. So this movie exposes a lot of those things, basically. So in the movie also, he is an outsider. So, depending on whichever country you are, the affirmative action and whatever we talk about, right? See, in America, it is blacks. So blacks are considered like, okay, they came from outside, as if the other people did not come from outside. A lot of English people came from England to US. A lot of Dutch people came. A lot of French people came. So sure. They're also outsiders. For some reason, blacks are considered outsiders. Similarly, in India and in some of the countries, Muslims are considered outsiders. In some countries, Hindus are considered outsiders. So no matter what, basically the tag is there of an outsider. And that outside inside is a hermetic principle where we need to integrate through love, accept all, love all, and you know, integrate. So he actually left a big message, a big void. And this is directly related to that Atlas comet which came. Because Atlas comet, all the comets, as I said initially also, Rahu is the king of meteors or comets. He is the outsider. He is the disruptor. So all the disruptions which happen are all Rahu. So Rahu is unhealed. So that is why in psychology and in our culture, he is expressed like this. Expressed like a vampire. Expressed like a ghost. Expressed as a werewolf. Expressed as a, you know, Michael Jackson maybe. Expressed as Sushant. Expressed as Joaquin Phoenix. You're understanding what I'm saying. So when...
Yes.
Are you there, Charles?
Yeah. Yes.
So please, yes. Saying yes. Otherwise, I think I have dropped off because my internet is down. So, yeah. So basically, he is the expressed part of that Hydra. Basically, ancient Greek mythology, Hydra or Lena was a fabulous water serpent with 9 heads killed by Hercules. And in the Bible also, dragon is killed, dragon's tail falls. So basically, a dragon, hydra, snakes, they all got a bad rap. Serpent
right.
is the one who makes Eve eat the apple. And then Adam eats. And then, you know, serpent is such a bad thing. Because of serpent, Adam and Eve came to this hell or Hades or whatever. They were expelled from the Garden of Eden. Serpent is a bad thing. But what apple did is they eat? They ate from the tree of knowledge.
That's right.
They did not eat. So what is serpent? Serpent means one who gives knowledge or wisdom. Serpent doesn't mean bad. Serpent is the one who tests. What is the Mayan prophecy saying? What is the Mayan system saying? That there are 13 worlds, right? And we are in the underworld. What does the Indian system say? Indian system says that, you know, we are 14 worlds, right? So basically this 13 number is associated with again 4. And 4 is what? Rahu. But how it has expressed itself? It has expressed itself as death. The number 4 is considered as an unlucky number in Chinese. Because it really? Is... And in Ireland, in the Western countries, the 13 number is not there in the elevator, right? So you have 11, 12, and then some people even skip 14. They say 15, 16. Why? Why so much fear? Fear psychosis. And what is that psychosis called? Triskaidekaphobia. I hope I got it right. So it is the ancient Greek meaning fear. Avoidance of the number 13. For 1970, at 13:13 CST, and suffered an oxygen tank explosion on April 13th.
True.
So whatever affirmations have been given by Angel, and also yes. I have given a lot of thing. Because see, there is something called a switch words, which Rhoda has given us. She is also a member of a society which talks about switch words. I will just show you that.
All right.
Partha, in fact, Sushant Singh Rajput's car number is also, another car number is also 1300, I think bike number.
Ah, okay. That's very interesting. Bike number. So that is also, like, you know, this... there is a healing technique, Charles, which is switch words. Okay, so when you say these words, a lot of healing happens. So, for example, for Sagittarius, I'm a Sagittarius, right? Okay. For me, the key word or switch word is forgive. So that is why probably it is working for me. So she is the author of this, Kat Miller. She is world famous on this particular thing, on switch words. She has invented all these switch words. Okay. So, you know, act, divine order, next, when. So these are the switch words. You can use these words Like if you want to, if you want to heal certain things. So for example, for Venus, you can, for Sun, it is womb. For Jupiter, it is wheat. Clear, concede, confess. So this, if you keep repeating these words, a lot of good things happens. So I think I have this. Yeah, see, for sign Sagittarius, I'm a Sagittarian. The switch word for all encounters is forgive. So since I started saying forgive, a lot of things have opened up for me.
Oh, beautiful.
So for an Aquarian, you have to say duck. Now, for Charles, you are a Cancerian. So for you, have to say womb.
All right.
Whenever you are, when people are judging you, I have seen a lot of recent videos. I don't want to bring
yes
that up, but I'm just telling you, a lot of should people are judging you, and a lot of unnecessary things are happening, and you are also getting angry and all that. So please, yeah, womb. Also, you know, for all, judge, give, God, womb. Okay, so this is a very interesting technique.
Very.
So I also say forgive. So if you see, a lot of things which I have, affirmations which me and Indil have given. So we have designed it together. We have worked on it together, and we have given it out to the world because it is like a divine inspiration. I mean, it just came to me. I mean, especially after that Swan event, when the comet, made a big sound. So after that, we have been seeing a lot of meteors in Australia, right? A lot of people are sharing on Facebook that, you know, comets, meteorites, they are seeing in Western Australia, especially in Perth. And I clearly told Perth, Perseus, Partha, all are one and the same. So that is what you are seeing all that. But of course, I don't want to take credit for each and everything that happens in the matrix. I'm just saying, you know, one of my subscribers, he keeps saying, why it happened in Bangalore? I mean, obviously, why it happened to Ezekiel or who was that?
Right.
Why did God come to him? The question is like that. Why did God come to Ezekiel with a chariot? Why not others? There are 7 billion people out there. Why it happened in Bangalore? See, let me tell you, not data is not everything. Data can help you till one point only. After that, it is fake.
True.
So certain things you cannot explain scientifically. Why the hell the sound was made only in Bangalore or near my area? Why it is happening in Perth or Partha? Why? And see, the song, this is the movie song in which Sushant acted, and there is a song in the movie which praises Shiva. Okay, so he went to the sun and he took photo of Shiva, right? So there is a song these are the lyrics. It says, when it was the time of churning of the ocean, there was a feud between the world for distribution of poison and nectar of immortality.
Okay.
You distributed the nectar of immortality and drank the poison. So what did Sushant do? Sushant drank the poison. He is the hanged man, isn't it? He is the one who died. He is the one who committed suicide. Now, how it is hanged man, I will show you that. Wait a second. I think I have closed. I'll just open it up. So there is the tarot card called Hanged Man.
Right.
It is the 12th tarot. See, it also looks like 4. See?
It does.
In 4 means Rahu. The hanged man shows a suspended form of T-shaped cross. See? Cross. Made of living wood. He is hanging upside down, viewing the world from a completely different perspective. And his facial expression is calm and serene, suggesting that he is in the hanging position by his own choice. So his own choice means suicide. He has a halo around his head, symbolizing new insight, awareness, and enlightenment. His right foot is bound to the trees, but his left foot remains free, bent at the knee and tucked in behind his right leg. His arm is bent with hands held behind his back, forming an inverted triangle. The man is wearing red pants representing human passion and a physical body, and blue vest for knowledge. The hanged man is card of ultimate surrender, of being suspended in time and martyrdom.
Very interesting.
Yes. And Let me open that. I need to open it. These windows, because they are now not needed. Okay, so I have to open again.
This is a lot of info.
I always come to Bible and other things also, because people should not think that, you know, Rahu is an Indian guy. These things are pertaining to ocean churning, which is an Indian legend related to India. No, please understand. All these are universal. Hanged Man is a depiction of Norse god Odin, who suspended himself from a tree in order to gain knowledge. See, Norse. So all the Europe is covered now. And there is also a Christian interpretation that portrays Judas and includes the bags of silver. So what did Judas do? Everybody knows what he did.
Yep.
What did he do?
He turned Jesus over.
Yes. He said, "You are a rabbi." He kissed on his cheeks. Isn't it?
Yeah.
So what is that? The action of betrayal. And then what did he do? He committed suicide. Isn't it? So yes. As per one story, he committed suicide. Judas committed suicide. What is suicide? What are those 30 silver coins? All Rahu, Rahu, Rahu. Rahu is everywhere. And that is what we need to learn. You know, it is not like, okay, only in India, Indian thing it is there. Cain and Abel, as I clearly showed, and I also told so many times that, you know, all the rupee and all the dollar symbols, they have cuts and slashes.
Yep.
And it looks like R, Sanskrit R, and see, head is cut off. That is Rahu. What is this called in ancient Babylonian thing? Isn't it cut?
Yep.
Isn't it split? Isn't it hanged man? So that means at a daily level, what are we doing? We're exchanging currency. And what is the currency? It is tainted. It is cursed. It is coin, cane. It is Rahu. It is cut off.
Mm-hmm.
Every day we are doing this. So this is called the ancient Babylonian blood money. Unfortunately, an Indian has to come and tell all this.
Yeah, fortunately.
No, what if I continue to make Hindi videos and not English videos? What if I never met you, Charles?
No, no.
Any Westerners, at least, even if 30 Westerners today are getting this knowledge and they can release the currency, coin, Cain, because Cain is the one who killed Abel, right?
Right.
So if you're able to release all that ancestral lineage, DNA, karma, because what is DNA? DNA is nothing but blood. What is blood? Blood is flowing from ancestor to, you know, current time.
Yes.
So I'll quickly go to the software. So let me see if it is open. I wanted to show something else also. So are you able to see the software, Charles?
Yes, there we are.
We have only 8 minutes. So basically in the software, this is a free software called Jagannatha Hora. People can cast their horoscope and they can see, you know, this is in English only. So Manushya means human, Deva, Manushya. So this is like, you know, you have all the bloodlines. You have the Deva means the God bloodline. You have the Asura, Rakshas bloodline. You have also human bloodline. Then you have all the saints inside of you. Then you have, you know, all the various Kumaras and all the Sanat Kumara and all. Maybe Angel will make a video on all the angelic cards, especially Sanat Kumara, Maitreya, Buddha and all later. And then, you know, you also have something called as karma. See, all these gods, they're inside of you, inside of your blood. Yama, the god of underworld, and also Ananta, the great serpent who holds all the 14 worlds, the atlas that is inside of you. So this is my horoscope. So, you know, it changes for person to person. And then see all the snakes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 snakes. So for me, Sun, Moon, Mars, they're all in snakes. Right? That is my karma.
Interesting.
And then if I go here, Mitra, that rising. Mitra, the rising sun. So I am like the Mitra or Mitra. Rising, Chris Mitra, Christmas, rising sun. I am like that. This is my sub, is actually related to subconscious mind. Then this is the entire matrilineal karma, meaning the seven generation of some, from the mother side. There I am Vishnu. And even from father side, I am Vishnu. So this is entire wow. D45. Yeah, so D45, this D45 shows you your entire seven generational karma of your ancestors from the father side. D40 is for the mother side. So people who are advanced students only can know this. And then this is entire your past life, D60. So this is the 60th division of your horoscope. It's called D60. So there Sudha. Sudha actually means nectar of immortality. Then Mercury, for me, Mercury is also in Amrita. Amrita is also nectar of immortality. So through your horoscope, you can come to know where, you know, your planets are and what kind of karma you are carrying in your blood.
Fascinating. So fascinating.
This is what it is. You know. So everything is there inside of you in your horoscope, and also Judas is in you. Jesus is in you. So don't think, oh, Jesus will come and save me just like that.
No.
Please. People who are thinking, oh, sun will come, plasma will come, so I will escape. No, no, no. There is no escape. You have to forgive. You have to move on. You have to forgive your ancestors. You have to seek forgiveness from your ancestors. You have to understand the matrix. You have to understand why the coins and currencies are the way they are. Why the world is in a mess. Why things are in the shape they are. It is because Rahu has not been healed. Rahu is our shadow side. Unless you heal the shadow side, you are not going anywhere. No event will happen. In fact, Creator will delay. He will not allow any EMP. He will not allow any plasma. It is not an automatic thing. Oh, you know, like many people, they keep mailing me about, you know, oh, you know, it is going to happen on June 21st. It is going to happen on June 25th. Sorry, let me break the news to you. It doesn't happen that way. It has to do with the 1,44,000. Souls, unless we are healed, we are ready like a bride, then only Jesus will come. It is not like, okay, I'm sitting here doing nothing, munching popcorn, and Jesus will come and he'll take us to the New Jerusalem. It doesn't happen that way. You have to be ready like a bride. Ready like a bride means you have to be burnt by the, you know, that desire to be with God and also raise yourself to the God vibration.
Yeah.
Frequency. So many things are there.
Oh,
otherwise, you will be looped back to this matrix, this testing ground. You are not going any way back because they are not doing their heat. Yes, I have only 1 minute. Yes, Charles, you can do the closing remarks.
No. Yes. There was just a pause in your voice and we lost you there for a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, so are you able to hear me now?
Yes, fine now.
Yeah. So I was saying, you know, plasma is not an automatic event.
Fascinating. Wonderful. Oh, you add such light to everything, Partha. Thank you so much. You add clarity. You are truly a gift and a blessing.
Yeah. So I hope everybody, you know, stops squabbling or, you know, arguing with you about, you know, 9/11 and all that. That is my closing. Forget about all that. Yeah. Forget about those things. Just focus on your own inner karma, your inner life. You understand things. Forget about, like, you know, about, you know, whether it was Osama bin Laden or whether it was the inner work of the government of Pentagon or whatever. Pentagon is also, you know, pentagram. That is the death kind of symbol. So, you know, nobody is holy here. Everybody, you know, every saint has a past and every sinner has a future.
Amen.
Everything has to be
Wow. Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
One of my favorite sayings.
Yeah.
One of my favorite sayings.
Yeah. And I also want to add one line that, see, this is your project, right, Charles? You are doing all the hard work. And I think some people shouldn't use some kind of negative word. And people should respect people for their hard work.
Thank you, Angel. Thank you so much.
That's why I'm with you. It's not important what do we think, whether we are agree with you or not with that point. But it's very important. See, because we share the same sky, earth and sun. There should be love in life, right? So at least people should listen what the person in front is telling. It's not like you throw words.
I agree.
Yeah.
I absolutely agree. You guys are wonderful. Thank you for lifting us.
Yes.
Thank you for bringing such positive light and healing. Namaste.
Namaste, Charles. Good night. Thank you, Charles.
Good night, Angel.
Yes.
Partha, good night. Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you.
You're wonderful. And I have nothing else to add. This was powerful.
Wow, today I'm seeing his face.
Yay! And what a smiling, beautiful face it is.
Yeah, you both are
you're the only one. My Indian trolls say that my mustache is bad and I am ugly.
No, it's okay. You both are very beautiful, beautiful souls. Charles and Partha are beautiful.
You all are too. Oh, so much. Thank you. Namaste and blessings.
Yes.
And we're wrapping this up. There's nothing more to add. Thank you, Partha. Thank you, Angel.
Bye. See you.
Bye-bye, guys.